These five operators are the most fun to play in all of Rainbow Six Siege. Stay tuned to see who they are. Let's get right into it.
Maybe it's 3 a.m. Had you on my mind, it's the first time.
Starting off at number 5, we have Orncs. Personally, I hate him when people play him in ranked because he's kind of useless, but he's actually pretty fun to mess around with in casual. His ability is a Monty's worst nightmare, and if you're a Monty and you see him, your ass better run. He can do some pretty cheeky runouts. Orncs has the MP5, Spaz, and Bailiff Pistol. With him, you can do some interesting rotates up through hatches, which allow for some unpredictable plays. When he was first coming out, I and many others thought he would be the main roamer and take over the game and certain maps completely, but obviously, that just wasn't the case. He is super enjoyable to mess around with, but there are just better operators to pick in rank than him, but he's easily still one of my favorite ones to mess around with. In the next patch, they're buffing his ability and giving his MP5 angle grip, so hopefully that'll make him a little bit better operator and increase his pick rate. Moving on to number 4, we ironically have Monting. I love this man. The sheer fear that some people feel when they see you is comparable to nothing. I love seeing them cower and shoot at my impenetrable shield, knowing their efforts are futile. Sorry about that. Anyways, Monty is so much fun, especially when you trap someone in a room. Like seeing them run around like a mice is kind of funny, especially when you can play cat and mouse with them. Monty is such an interesting operator, especially since if you use him right in ranked, he can change the entire flow of the game, but if he's used wrong, you're basically throwing, and understanding how to play him in ranked is vital to winning. If you use the Magnum, you're easily a Chad, but if you use the puny little bitch pistol, get out of my fucking face. Monty is also 6'3", and I wouldn't want to go near his tall ass. Also, that motherfucker is 51. 51. Like, you think he would retire at that age, but no, he wants to be in a counter-terrorism group. Moving on to number 3, and please don't hate me for this, but it's Blitz. And yes, I know, he's toxic to play, but hear me out. It is the funniest shit when you flash someone and they spaz out running around in circles and shooting frantically. So you guys are gonna hate me even more when I first say this, but you won't after I explain. I mained him for a very long time, and yes, I know that sounds really bad, but I mained him before his stupid ass rework, when he was a 3-armor, and he had the crouch walk everywhere, and he was a sitting duck in almost any situation, but I mastered the art of the Blitz. I knew how to get close without being noticed, and I was pretty damn good at it. Hell, I even spent $20 worth of cosmetics on him. Just look at him. Isn't he majestic? With all that out of the way, he is a serious pain to deal with. Usually in ranked when I play one, it's either someone who didn't mean to pick him and got him by accident, or it's someone who has 8,000 hours on him and has mastered his movement completely. The best way to deal with the Blitz is shoot his legs when he's running, and if he's crouched, then shoot his shoulders, but be aware he could aim down sights, but the time it takes to be able to do that is really long, so you should be able to adjust. I promise you if you count him like that, he's easy to kill and there shouldn't be a problem. Listen, I promise I'm not a simp for Blitz, but the only time you should play him is in casual. But if you do use him in ranked, you have no skill. He's fun to mess around with in casual, but not the move in ranked, and he's easily one of my favorite ops to play. And because it's just so funny when you kill people and then they send you hate mail to casual, but it's okay because it's casual. Number 2 will probably surprise you, but my second favorite op to play is Demfli Amaru. She's a 50-50 chance of glorious success or embarrassing failure. You better pray that no one is looking at that window that you're repelling in, or else you're pretty much fucked. When someone says a leap of faith, they think of jumping off a waterfall or skydiving. Well, my dumbass thinks of using the Agar hook because that shit is so unpredictable you have no idea what's going to happen. I will say, if you plant a bomb in a site and the hatch is open, that defender is pretty much screwed, but that is one of the most rare things to happen, and it's never happened to me. If any of you guys watched my Void Edge operator tier list video, I dissed Amaru hard about the fact that her gadget is useless, but next season they are making it a lot faster and harder to detect, which will make her more viable because her guns and her loadout overall is one of the best in the game. Like, she's arguably one of the best primaries on attack and the SMG-11, come on, that's insane. I truly do think Amaru is going to be really good next season. Don't be shocked if you see her in a Pro League match or two, because she's going to be very, very nasty. My number one most enjoyable operator to play in all of Rainbow Six Siege has to be our Lord, T'Chunka. No one, and I mean no one, is superior to this god. He is immortal, and even if he dies in the round, his presence will affect the opponents for the rest of their lives. There is nothing scarier than a T'Chunka spawn peeking you with the glory of a bulletproof face shield, and the worst part is, he isn't scared, you are. The scariest part isn't even that, it's the fact that they're reworking T'Chunka and making it to where he can shoot incendiary grenades, and I mean a shit ton of incendiary grenades. And his weapon is now his LMG, and it can make rotations and most likely will do a lot of damage as well. Many don't realize this, but T'Chunka will be number one meta next season, and when his rework is released, everybody will be playing him. Hopefully you all get the experience of how fun he is before his rework comes out, and experience the spawn peaking, the 10% win rank, and how amazing he really is. If you guys made it to the end of the video, make sure you guys comment down below, Chonka is God. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It was fun as hell to make. But anyways, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you guys never miss a new stream or upload. But anyways, I'm going to leave you guys with the rest of this Chonka Ace. Anyways, enjoy.
Versus, don't forget that.
Swapping mags!
Op 4 has located a bomb. If you remain you will be spotted by hostiles.
Fucking news going down. Oh my god, my eyes are missing. I'm one of the planting right now, if I'm correct. Oh, that's a nice first.
Op 4, last operator standing.
Hey. I think I need a headset. No, I'm sorry, here it is.